Hello everyone and welcome to Admixture Studios. So in continuation to the last video wherein we added everything to our database, now our data reside within MySQL database on a local installation, and this is how our API is configured. So we have API accessible on our local host. Okay, so now what we are going to do is we are going to switch from the current data source to the database to which we moved our data. So this is our website, this is how it looks like right now, and you can see pretty much everything is getting populated. Now we want to change this. So how to change this? Let's go to code and we'll have to make these changes one by one. So let me close everything and I'll show you step by step. So in this video, first and foremost we'll start with the environment file here. The current API URL is showing as api/post, but which is not the case now. So let me copy our URL from here and paste it here. So this is https localhost api api.php/records. Okay, so this is our URL. Let's save this. Okay, going back, we'll go to config service. This is the service which has got everything. I mean, all the calculations are getting done here. So replace this AMI URL with API URL variable. So this will be reflecting here. After that, we made this change. Save this too. Now let's look at the functions. Do we have to make any change? So okay, get post function, let's say. So we are sending a request to the post. This is this.api URL. We need to add /post, right? Okay, so we can add this to a template. Okay, and this should work. This is my variable, so let me put this in a curly braces. So dollar this.api URL /posts. Is that post or posts? Let me see. Records /posts. Yeah, it is post. POSTS. Okay, done. This is done. Let's go further. And get setting function we will not be using. Okay, yes, get setting. So here are two things we are using. If we have a ID, there we are appending it to it. Otherwise we are just using the database name. So we would want the API to be changed with this third API URL, and similarly here. What next? Let's look at the update post this dot API URL. Okay, and we would need the ID here, so let's do this /posts/the ID. So we'll take the ID from the function. We'll see how to take that input. Further moving on, next we have add post again posts. Let's update this. Okay, get post by ID this dot api url /post posts /id. This should work. So post is done, at post is done, update for post we'll relook at. Get setting is done. And observable, this is also done. Okay, let's save this. Okay, now we'll go to our module. First and foremost thing is the app module. So here in app module we defined in-memory web API. So everything is getting routed to this in-memory data service. We don't want to do this now. So we can easily comment this out. Saving this again. Now all the requests will be routed to the actual server. Let's see. Let's go back to our browser. Wait, here. So you see, tons of errors. There are so many errors because now we have switched, but it is not getting any data. So this data, these actions, menu, and everything is empty. So let's find this data. Where is it? So back to code. Let's start with the first page that is called home page. So we'll go to home component and see. So now you see we changed it to page data record. So let me go here, copy one of these, okay, and paste here. This is a number. Next line, name is a string. Tagline, and this is also a string. Title, again a string. Description is also a string. Okay, let's keep the spacing. Removing double quotes to avoid any confusion here. Done. So we are pretty much done with the definition. Now save this. Now look at the function, which is what is doing. So when we call this function, we are saying that in this call this function with pages as the database name and header as the ID, but our ID is no longer a text, it is a number. So now our ID is, let's see, where is the header? Header is ID number 9. So let's change it this way, ID number 9, and this also needs to be updated to number. Now everything's set. So we'll be able to fetch the correct set of data, but we need to update this in the comment. So in the comment, what we want here on the top, everything says okay, but here, so it's header dot heading. So instead of heading, we want tagline. Okay. Title, tagline, we got tagline, we got title, and then description. So in the button text we want, see, we never organized it in that way, but let's see, I am changing this to name so that it shows header. We want do some action description. Okay, let me copy description. So here, I'm copying description. Let's save this and see. Do we have an update? Oh yes, I can see the changes now. but this does not look good. So I can change this to tagline, this to title, and save again. Yes, we have Administer Studios. Everything is starting to look now, and it is able to fetch. It's able to fetch from the database. So this is pretty much what we will do for all other components. So let's start with our website component, which was there on the top here. Okay, so going there, let's see. Next is website block component. Oh no, social component. Website block is just the block. So social component, it's calling the websites. Done, should be able to fetch. Okay, so now let's look at it. Okay, it is using the config server, calling this function return this dot config that websites. Okay, so and subscribe data equals to this dot socialize social sites equals to data. Okay, so we look at this module, it looks all good, but the difference lies, as I believe, is in the way we fetch the data. So let's say when we are fetching this data website, it is giving me a JSON record, and this record further has a array, and this is what we want. So if we make, we need to make some change to for the config function, or we can make change to every function which is calling. So it's better we make change to the configuration. Why? So let's go there. So here is our file. Now here in this file, if we see get settings, so in get settings we are using two different URLs. This one is working for us because we called one header with the ID and it worked for us, but this is not working because whenever we are calling database, not returning me the direct array, rather it's returning a single object called records, which further has an array. So we need to change this. Okay, let's copy this, cut from here. Now because we have two conditions, we need two type of returns. So this is working. Okay, so when we have database, so to use map settings, and instead of settings alone we want to return setting records. That's what you are getting, correct? So now what would happen is, in case we have our ID in our request, then this part of the function would be called. So that way it will return one single record, and here it is returning complete set of records as an array, as we are expecting in each of our component. Let's save this. I think this should solve our problem. Let's see. Okay, so yes, we have these website icons available. Yes, menus also populated. Okay, this icons are also coming. Let's see if this menu is working. Okay, when we go to about, we don't see the complete thing because we need to update each page. So let's do this one by one. So we'll start with the about page. Okay, let's go to, to avoid confusion, let me just close everything here. We'll go to about page. Where is about? Here it is. And about page. Here is our page component. So we have intro, tagline, title, description. So instead of intro. Okay, let's copy what we did in header. So in home, in the homepage component, we can copy everything as it is. copy and go to about. Okay, so this is done. We want to change this to number, and here intro. Let's see, where is intro? Intro is the first one, so let's change it to 1. Save. Is it working? Yes, it is working. Coming on to next, we got services. I don't see much thing, much other things here under services. Okay, services page, the services component. Okay, change this to the number. Services, where is services? Third one. So number 3 should work. We'll go to clients, client page. In client page component, let's copy, paste, change this. This is number, client is number 2. Save. Then contact us. Contact us is a different story altogether. Footer, let's go to footer. Okay, footer again, we do have a different story, so let's update this. And get footer, this dot footer, this dot footer, and get footer, it is calling the get config function. We don't want to use get config function, rather we want to use get setting. Get settings. Return this dot config dot get setting. Okay, let's copy this function from about page. So get page data, this is the function we want to use. So we'll replace this get page data, this dot footer equals to the data, this dot footer. Okay, number subscribe, and let's call this function. Get page data, pages, comma, what is the number? 7. Okay. Single quote. This should also work now. Let's see at the home page. Okay, seems some error with the footer. Footer, we're getting ID, description, footer, tagline. Okay, we need to make some changes to the template because it is mapped with different properties. So the developer link, where is the developer link? So developer link is there, it's part of description. Okay, footer dot developer link, changing it to description. Copyright text, I'll change it with, where is it? Tagline. offer is the title. So these choices we are making because we are using a standard Tableau format MySQL database, where it is preferred, it's always preferred to have a JSON supported or document supported database like MongoDB. So we will work on MongoDB too, but let's complete this first. Okay, it's working now. It's visible, everything is good. Coming on to the next page, now let's fix gallery. So gallery, we have gallery as the name of the table. We'll go here. Let's close these. Gallery page, gallery component. Okay, we have got images, we got string, and then this is the description. Description we can readily copy from footer gallery. This is how it's going to be. After this, we need images. Okay, images, get block data images. Get block data is nothing but get setting and the database name. And it is calling the which one? Images. No. The name of the table is change source gallery. This should also work now. And this is working, but we do not have these things. Okay, let's see. Oh, need to change the number. Okay, number 6. And here it will be number. Yes, back in the shape. Testimonials. So see, it's pretty much easy. It's very easy for us now. So we'll just complete this quickly. Gallery is done, footer is done. Gallery. Oh, not that cat. Testimonial. Go to testimonial. Testimonial page. Let's copy from here. This is pasted done. Change this testimonial to the number. Where is the number? Number four. And this is also done. Then price, go to price bar, price page. Okay, change this again. Number and price. Where is the price? 5. 5. So what we have done? We have done intro, client, service, testimonial, price, gallery, footer, blog. Now blog is the next one. This is done. Now we'll go to blog. Here in blog, we'll go to blog page. This is number 8, and this needs to be changed to number. And this is good. Let's save this and see. Home. Working, about, working, services, working, gallery, yes, working, testimonials, working, clients, working, pricing is also working, blog, yes, it's asking for logging, this is also working, contact us, yes, this is also working, subscribe, yes, this is working too. Let's go back to home. So we're pretty much done with everything. So now, next thing, what do you think is left? The only thing that is left now is to do the login part. So Let me explain to you now. So the login part so far is was being taken care of by our memory component, the in-memory database component, and we prepared two methods. So let me show you those methods. Back to in-memory database service. So we have a user table here. Okay, now in this user table, we'll close all of the tables. Okay. Done. So now, if you look at, this is a get token function. So we created a get token function. Then we have another function called get required information from post, get articles, and this function called post. So there is where the login is made to work. So now if I look at this function, we'll see that it checks if we have login in our URL or not. If login is there, it just follows the standard process, and what it actually is doing is extracting the email out of the body and the password and comparing it with the similar record in our user table. And in case it finds the record, it is creating a user body and then returning it to us along with the token. So this was all dummy and everything. Now we want to do it in real time. So what we will do is we'll create a PHP file. So we already have a file, API file. Here is our API file. So this file allows me to fetch data. So let me show you. If I type USERS, users, so it is showing me users too, but that's not what we are looking for, right? That's not what we want. The API first and foremost should not allow to see the user database. Okay, secondly, this API is currently open. It does not have any restrictions, so anybody having access to API can come and see. There is no restrictions at all. So we want to change that somehow. We'll see how to change that. Second is the login part. So next is we need to have one more file at server that allows me to validate my username and password without exposing anything, and hence facilitate the login and sign up. So that's what we are going to do in the coming video, because that would require a little bit more elaboration and clarity. So that's I'm working on right now. We'll complete and share it to you all. So that's all for this video. Thank you for watching. We'll complete the login part in the subsequent video. Stay tuned. Thank you.